are all dead. Without horses, we cannot hunt. Without hunting, we will starve. This is another act of war.
I see that.
Men have helped me before, and I have money.
Put your money away, son. What do you think, Charles?
You know I told your father I will not fight over some horses.
But I made no such promise. Come along.
Yeah, Arthur, we must go with them to try to stop things from getting out of hand.
I guess. Come along.
We can get them more horses.
I know. I understand Eagle Flies is angry, but I don't see how this will help anything.
Especially not with Dutch whipping them up into a frenzy. We got enough folks coming after us without adding an army to the list.
You're going to let these bastards walk all over you? No, you're not. This is all that's wrong with this world. Okay, young man, lead the way.
The horses are on a boat near Van Horn. I have a man waiting for us there with some canoes.
Surely this can be done without killing anyone.
Of course. What will be. Anyway, son, tell me about this Colonel Favors.
He's a vile man. He and his regiment take pleasure in persecuting us. All the young have been taken from our reservation, shipped off to reform schools. Many women, too. The old are weak and sick, but they deliberately withhold medicine and supplies from us.
This ends today. You have my word on that.
Why are you getting involved in this, Dutch?
You know me. We shoot fellers as need shooting. We save fellers as need saving. Feed them as need feeding.
Not this again. It's been quite a while since we helped anyone but ourselves, and even you know that.
I told you. Noise. We need noise, Arthur. Noise. And faith.
I still don't know what that means.
Stop questioning and think. Just think for a second. The Pinkertons have had time to reinforce. The civilized world is closing on us. Who knows what else Molly told them? We need to move towards a conclusion. Now.
Sure, but what's this got to do with any of that?
Some good, honest conflict between the army and the Indians might be just the distraction we need. Kill two birds with one stone. Cornwall was funding the Pinkertons' assault on us. Why do you think I dealt with him? With Cornwall gone, the government is far more likely to divert them to other issues, especially if there's one more scandal. And then we can slip away. Like I said, we just need that noise and one more score. You know, I went back for the chest I had hidden outside Shady Bell, and we're close, Arthur. That dynamite, the railroad contract with the army, it was all in those papers Micah found. I have a plan. You just have to trust me.
There's Peta. These men, like I said, they'll help us.
I got the canoes. The boat is still moored in the channel.
Good. Come on, let's go.
We need to get that boat ashore. I think the best plan is to paddle up there silently, board her. And when we got control, we'll deal with that anchor, float away. We'll be ashore before anybody even knows what happened.
not to kill anyone, Arthur.
Good luck.
Try not to kill anyone, Arthur.
You mind the horses? I need a smoke.
Raise you.
What the hell?
We're taking back what's ours.
I'm gonna blast the hell out of you.
Confused. We need to round them up. I'll get these four, Arthur. Can you go after the others?
Okay. Over here, come on.
Thank you.
Come here. Come on. Come here. Come on. Come here. Come on.
The horses are confused. We need to round them up. I'll get these four, Arthur. Can you go after the others?
Okay. Over here, come on.
Seems like Uncle Sam likes you fellas even less than he likes us.
So it goes. My father doesn't want to fight again. Will one of you help me return the horses to my men?
Well, Arthur... Arthur needs to rest. I will. I like you, son. And after the horses, are we going to wait for the army to come and wreak its revenge?
I hope not.
Of course we ain't. Now let's go check out that fort of theirs.
Is this a good idea?
This is the only idea. And it is one that will suit both of our purposes.
Fighting the army ain't wise.
Stop worrying. Oh, and Sadie told me about Combe. Meet us at Doyle's Tavern in Saint Denis when you can. Shall we go, son?
Certainly.
We'll start some light reconnaissance out at Fort Wallace, and when Combe's dealt with, you come meet us there. We'll set up a good spot for you.
I don't know, Dutch.
Yeah, well, I do. This is exactly the distraction that we need.
Your father said that fighting was an impossible gamble. There's no winning for you in this.
Father need not know anything. He'd rather live in ignorance.
Come along, gentlemen.
Your father would rather you did not do anything so foolish. I said I would stop this from happening. Would you talk to him?
Speak with Rangeful.
Yes. Would you?
Sure. Oh. I'll speak with him. You head on back to camp, check on the others, touch his behavior. It's...
I understand.
Thank you, Arthur.
There he is, old Black Lung Morgan.
Shut up.
Was you followed?
Excuse me?
Was you followed?
You know who you're talking to.
I ain't sure. I ain't sure about much no more. All I know is there's law whenever you're around.
Is that so? Because it seems to me that since you've been riding with us, there ain't been nothing but trouble. Stirring things up all the time, getting in Dutch's ear. Seems wherever you is, there's Pinkertons and vice versa. So you better watch your goddamn mouth, boy! Or...
Take it easy, cowboy. You're gonna do yourself a mischief, way you're heading.
Micah, shut it!
He started it! Dutch says we is to go on with plans to create a diversion. We gotta get some explosives to blow up the bridge. Keep the army out of here a few days.
I think it's a real bad idea.
I don't think Dutch cares too much what you think.
That's clear.
We gotta confuse him one last time. Then he and I will head to Blackwater, collect the money, and help everyone leave. He's got a boat lined up.
Blackwater's a fool's errand. Everyone knows it. Even a greedy moron like you.
It's Dutch's choice, Arthur. You're just a senior gun, same as the rest of us. Only you ain't well.
I'm fine.
Then you'll do Dutch's bidding. Which is robbing a stage that's coming from Annisburg full of explosives.
Rob a stage. All we seem to ever do is rob a stage, you and me.
Not me. You two, I got my own planning to do. You boys got this.
Shit. Guess we have. Come on, Arthur.
And Cowpoke, take it easy. You could do with a vacation, hmm?
All right, let's go. Hold.
Have fun, boys.
Micah says we should jump it as soon as it comes through Van Horn.
So you're taking orders from him now?
I'm taking orders from Dutch, same as always.
Apparently I'm becoming unhinged. You hear about Dutch killing Cornwall?
Hey, hold up a second. Pinkerton Patrol, over there. Okay, I think we're clear. Let's head off.
So you was just talking about something?
Well, that needed to be done.
Right now? With the Pinkertons breathing down our necks?
See, I'm starting to think that you've gone soft, Morgan. Hold up here. So, the wagon will be coming from that way, down from Annisburg. And it'll take the two of us to stop it completely, or it'll never get done. So, I was thinking, you go play dead, and I'll take care of them.
No, I'm the better shot, and you're the better actor. No, you play dead, and I'll cover you.
I got that. I got that. Oh, that's them coming now, I think. It'll be quite the show.
These people.
Move, you wicked! Move!
Come on, let's get you out of...
See if we can get this back to camp without blowing ourselves up. Nice shooting back there.
Nice truck play.
Comes naturally. I could use a drink after that.
No. Just never goes easy no more, does it? Sense to you?
It's a distraction. So it ain't meant to make sense.
It should to us. It's our plan.
You know, look, there's Micah up ahead.
Great. Whoa!
So, you got it?
We got it. Yes, we got it.
What's wrong, Arthur?
Nothing at all, boss.
John. Go drive this over to Bacchus Bridge. Get a hidden ear there.
He really does think he's in charge.
You go on ahead. I need to speak with Arthur. Good work, son.
What's going on?
Listen. I know we ain't always seen eye to eye, and you find me irritating and a threat, and I like to annoy you. But right now, I need better from you, Arthur.
Okay, Micah. Whatever you say.
I ain't the bad guy you think I am, Arthur. But I am a survivor. Stick with me and you'll live. Oh, the bridge is probably a two-man job. You should probably go help Marston.
Why don't you?
Like I said, Dutch and I got planning to do for the train. There's a big picture here, Arthur. Trust me.
I know, girl. Just give me a second.
Yeah.
Let's see what we got. Must be a way off. Must be close. Easy, easy. Yep.
Get back.
Here we are. Got some ground to cover. Don't seem close. Okay, where are you?
Come in. You don't sound very well.
I'm not. I think I'm dying.
Then I hope you find peace.
I don't know too much about peace.
Apparently not. Did you have fun with my son, the impetuous prince? I believe you went on a raid with him.
I'm sorry.
I suppose I lack the grandeur of a conventional king.
I don't know too many kings.
Colonel Favors. He has already exacted some measure of revenge for the raid. Two women were assaulted by his men.
I'm very sorry about all of this.
Yes. Sometimes the correct path, the bravest path, is the least obvious and also the gentlest. I'm a great disappointment to my son.
Your son seems to want a war.
My son thinks there is glory in death. Maybe he's right. But for me, I saw death being handed out so freely by the most foolish of men, I never could equate it with victory. Glory has come in service. Maybe. Maybe not, I don't know.
I've killed a lot of people. For a whole lot of dumb reasons, and I ain't never seen much glory in it.
Well, your friend, Mr. Vanderlyn, he talks a lot. I don't know him, but my son is easily led.
I'm not sure I get you.
Well, perhaps we could go for a ride. I'm an old man. My whole life I have tried to bring peace.
But I ain't doing so good.
Then maybe you can take pity on my plight. Please. It won't take long. Maybe I can help you with that cough.
Sir! I'm glad I caught you, sir.
Captain Monroe, do you know my friend, Mr. Morgan?
No, sir. I don't have the pleasure.
Arthur Morgan.
It's an honor, sir.
How can I help you, Captain?
I was just in Saint Denis. I spoke with the mayor. It's not good news, I'm afraid. May I ride with you for a little?
Of course. Follow me.
So where are we going?
I want to show you a site up in the mountains that's long been sacred to me. A place for reflection and healing. What is this news, Captain Monroe?
Yes, sir. As I mentioned, I did speak again with the mayor and the Bureau of Indian Affairs in Saint Denis at length. But regrettably, it appears the oil company has already received approval to move forward with drilling on the reservation's land.
I suppose there's much. So what does that mean for us now?
I'm not sure just yet. I didn't get the impression anything would be happening for a few months. I'm very sorry, sir. I did everything I could.
I know, Captain.
And I assure you I will continue to do as much as I can. Mr. Morgan, would you have time to help me at all? I would rather certain actions were taken by friends outside the tribe. Any...
Sure, I can help.
That's good news. Thank you. Come meet me on the reservation whenever you can. Anyway, gentlemen, I won't take up any more of your time. I'll see you both soon.
Sure.
Thank you, Captain.
Enjoy the ride.
We'll continue on this way. I'm going to look for some herbs to give you. Ah. Oh. See the wolves over there feasting on that horse? Brutality and beauty are both all around us. Yet so often, we're unable to see past our own grievances. This is what I try to teach my son.
Yeah! Go on, get at it!
Good. There was no need to harm them. but don't feel like you have to. It's a beautiful ride ahead if you need some time to think.
Yeah! Hold.
So, we don't know each other too well, but I wanted to speak to you about your son. I was there on the raid to steal back those horses, and, well...
Sorry, hold up a moment. That'll have to wait. Some of the plants I need will be growing down here. This is what I was looking for. English mace. Okay, let's continue on.
Now, I was saying... Well... You know something of Dutch, I think.
Yes, a little. Mostly from your friend Charles.
I don't know why Dutch is getting involved in your situation, and...
Watch
this ain't
out.
Easy to say, but I just don't trust that he's got your son's best interests at heart.
So what can we do?
I don't rightly know. Charles and I just thought you should be aware. Maybe there's a way to stop things from getting any more out of control.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan. Let me give this some thought. Be careful. There are some steep turns up ahead, but the views are beautiful from up here.
You know, I had a son once, years ago. Don't talk about him much.
No, what was his name?
Isaac. His mother, Eliza, was a waitress I met. When she got pregnant, she knew who I was, what my life was. I didn't want to promise nothing I couldn't keep, but I said I'd do right by them. Every few months, I'd stop by there for a few days. He was such a good kid. She was too, I guess.
Wait, stop here. I want to pick some ginseng. We can talk more about this later. This will combine well. Wait there. I'll put these in your saddlebag. Mix these together. It tastes awful. But it'll help to keep your strength up. All right, let's go. It's not much further now. You were saying before you rode off?
He was such a good kid. She was too, I guess. Just a kid, 19.
What happened?
I got there one day and saw two crosses outside. I knew right away. Turned out some bastards had come through. Robbed them. Shot him dead. And offered $10. It hardened me. Feeling that kind of pain. But I know now that you don't get to live a bad life and have good things happen to you.
I think you're being hard on yourself.
Maybe. All I can do now is try and make some things right. I appreciate the herbs, but I think it's gonna take more than that. I saw a doctor, and he says I'm in a pretty bad way.
I'm sorry to hear that.
This situation we're in, me, Dutch, and the others, I don't know how long I got, but some of them, they still got a chance to have a life. I just think it
If I could give them that, then maybe this ain't all for nothing.
I think there is much you can still do, Mr. Morgan. It's just up ahead.
What's happened?
No!
It can't be.
No! They destroyed everything!
Now I need to find the Chinupa.
Help me look around, please. The Chinupa is gone.
Of course. What is it?
A ceremonial pipe. There must be some clue as to what happened here. I cannot believe this.
Whiskey. Bastards are having a party up here. There's some logs here they must have used as kindling.
An empty bottle of whiskey.
Well, if they drank all that, they couldn't have gotten too far.
Yeah, well, still no sign of the Chinupa. Smoke. Do you have any binoculars? Oh, there they are. These brave men. Some of Colonel Favor's men. They must have been the ones who did this.
Are you surprised this happened?
Not at all. But I hope we were past this.
Well, you got land they want. Land with oil.
They moved us here. They've taken everything we had. I signed 3 treaties myself, and they've broken each one. Now they've taken the last hope. Now my people are going to want a war. A war they can't win.
Not if I get it back.
Get it back?
Yeah, I'm gonna go in, get your chin up, and no one will be any the wiser.
would you do that?
Well, you can't go. They know why you'd come.
I don't have any money.
No, I don't need your money.
Please see if they have our sacred items. But try not to hurt anyone.
I'll try to ensure that they never even know I'm there, but actions don't always go the way you plan.
You said you were going to look for the Chinoompa. Not going down there? If you could do this for me, I would very much appreciate it.
Easy now.
Come on, girl. Tell me you found it.
Here. I got your things, I think.
Yes. Thank you.
I'm very sorry about this.
Even sacred things are only things. People, the heart, matter more. Was anyone hurt?
Yes.
It's a bad business. I should not have let you do this for me, but perhaps it will stop a bigger massacre. With these, maybe I can calm my people. Maybe I can calm my son.
I hope so.
Thank you. Take those herbs I gave you, please. And most of all, I hope you can find peace within yourself.
He's a man who, not so long ago, I would have found weak and pathetic. Now I see as wise and thoughtful and sensible. I would love to help him, or at least stop Dutch pushing his son to do something real stupid.
Yeah. Come on. Thank you.
blind?
Yeah! Hello!
Is someone there? Anything to spare for a blind man? Is someone there? Hello?
Here you go, friend.
Bless you, mister. Truly, you're a saint. Yes, sir. There should be more people in the world like you. God bless.
Girl?
Selling. All right, let's have a look. Hope you're not expecting much for it. Boy, the things I can make with this. I'd wager I can travel faster with this stall in tow than you or anyone can with nothing but a horse and a saddle. It's not about speed. It's about knowing the land.
Much appreciated. Mine's my load.
Hello.
Quality hide makes the hardiest clothes around. Don't doubt it. Trees, Big Valley, Roanoke. I run this stall just about everywhere. Best way to source the skins. Yeah, that can be reinforced, no trouble. A lot of folk hunt, but not so many know their way around a needle and thread. It's good business, I'm telling you. Yep.
How do you do?
Get going, will you?
his shirt!
I knew Saint-Denis would call you back to me sooner or later. Come in.
Oh, it's you. Are you all right, mon ami? You know we have a good doctor in town.
Yes, I already saw him.
Ah, okay. Très bien. In that case, how may I help you? Sure, I'll take a look.
Maybe next time, huh?
Mister. Oh, you come.
Welcome back.
Hey,
eyes open.
Okay, let's take a look at it.
Frederick got himself some of that Doc Crockett's miracle tonic. And let me tell
you... Pleasure doing business with you.
...a wedding night all over again.
What are you doing?
Yeah,
why is this happening?
Rasmus, sir!
Get going.
All right, girl.
Hey there, mister.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Out of the damn way.
Fantastic. You Americans are nothing but shysters and traitors and slippery-tongued bullsuckers.
I'm inclined to agree.
Here, help me, please. Back to work with a bloody smile. No problem, Marco. You are the great genius, so we shove the hot poker up the ass. Say thank you, Marco. Thank you. Oh, thank you.
What are you, some kind of European toy maker?
No, I am a fucking genius with poker up the ass, like I say. Toy maker. Hello?
Do I look like I should entertain children?
No.
No, he says. No. I am the savior of the mankind, Bobby. Yes, you meet him. Professor Marco Dragic, the one the silver-tongued American betrayed and not paid the money to. Yes, he told the shit, man.
So, what's this toy about?
It is not a toy, Big Nuts. It is demonstration of my genius, of my ideas about the source of life.
Oh, it's a toy boat.
Yes, it is a toy boat that I can power remotely using electricity in ways you cannot see.
Good for you. Ways I cannot see.
And still the investors will not come. Just a couple of old ladies and a moron.
Ladies, please.
Ladies! Gentlemen! Enchanté. Hello. Hello, sir. Okay. How is the piles? Yeah? Good, good, good. Okay. My friends, you are about to witness history. A demonstration of my infinite insight. All of us, we feel old. You are old. Aww. But maybe I can make you immortal. Using waves you cannot see. I will power this boat.
You're a goddamn fraud. And this buffoon dressed up like a buffoon is a stoolie. I watch them conspire, you morons.
What? I never met this buffoon before 2 minutes ago. Isn't that right?
Which part of it?
So, Professor, show us your magical toy boat. Only this time let the buffoon control it. Check if there's any funny business.
Oh, this ain't nothing to do with me.
Come, please, please. It is easy. Any moron could do it, and I am about to prove that. Here, take this, and this, and... don't touch that. Use these ones to steer and this one to shoot torpedoes, okay? Yes, now blow up the little battleships and avoid the sea mines. They have magnets attached. Make a nasty explosion if they touch the boat. Okay! If this silly dimwit can use torpedoes on boat to destroy the battleships... technology can do in the hands of certified genius! And I have a certificate.
Hey, it's doing what I'm telling it.
Of course it is doing. Now tell it to do closer to battleship and shoot with torpedo. Watch the mine. Okay, look out for mine. You see what he does? No wire like telegraph. No pulley system underwater.
Only waves in the air.
This is remarkable. Think of those poor boys on the H.L. Hunley. 8 of them perished to a mere 5 on the Housatonic. And what a way to go. Trapped in a box at the bottom of the bay. I suppose you intend to make an unmanned killing machine?
You misunderstand. This is the secret to life. Not death. The transmigration of the soul. I make lifeless metal breathe like man.
Well, I'm not sure about that.
Torpedoes do not have so much range. I am an invisible wave engineer, not a rocket physicist.
There, all gone for you.
Yes, you see what he does? Now, bring the boat back to the dock.
That sure was something, but I'm not sure what, if anything, was proven here.
The demonstration's not over yet. Any fool can explore the sitting dock. Next, he will show you the moving docks.
Well, all right.
Let me just reload.
This is really remarkable.
This is just a demonstration of my prowess, sir. The real miracles require investment. Now the dimwit will use invisible waves to destroy the little sailing boats before they get to other side of pond. Still avoiding magnetic mines.
Well, he'll attempt to, at least.
Shush! You're not here for this smart talk. The steam train, the telegraph machine, the motor car. They will all seem pedestrian in comparison to this technology. We are not reliant on wires or coal or gasoline. No, just rays in the air. Like the voice of God.
And funding from us?
And funding from you, of course. But what thing to fund? What an opportunity! No one is stupid enough to pass this up. Now the...
Look who rules the seas.
Very good, very good. Now bring in the boat back here. Foolproof. Undeniably foolproof. But you are not fools. As I say, any fool, huh? Thank you, thank you.
What is that?
It is the stuff of life, sir.
It's incredible.
No, no, no. Incredible things are in my lab, back at Dover Hill. That will astound all of you. Mr. Marcel, can I count on your support?
Well, this is expensive.
It is immortality, sir. It is very cheap. Perhaps over lunch.
Maybe.
I'm gonna go.
Oh, yeah, of course. And thank you. If you're ever up near Dover Hill, pay me a visit. There, I will really amaze you. I hope you will forgive my...
Maniac! Don't you have anything else
to
do?
Right now! Call the Manson!
Don't you worry about me.
There you are.
Here I am.
Come on, let's go.
Let's go where? And why are you so riled up?
Today is a great day, Arthur. Today is the day they are going to hang Colm O'Driscoll.
So?
Rather they hang him or I shoot him.
Oh, they are gonna hang him.
Yeah, and not before time.
That boy's been on the gallows more than most. I wouldn't count anything until his neck's broke.
Well, nor would I. Which is why, despite us being wanted men, we're gonna attend the event ourselves.
And follow him onto the scaffold?
Well, let's hope not. But if I could see that son of a bitch breathe his last, I think I'd die a happy man. We are gonna disguise ourselves.
In this?
In this.
Okay.
Come on.
Well, don't we just look the part?
We'll cut through the alley to get to the gallows. We keep our weapons holstered, our disguises on, and our wits about us.
Mrs. Adler, might I say, being a fancy woman of Saint-Denis suits you.
I'd dress up like the Queen of Sheba if it meant seeing that son of a bitch swing.
Colm hung me up, nearly butchered me. That don't mean I'm comfortable in this woolen coat.
You made it out of that predicament, as I remember, Mr. Morgan. My husband weren't so lucky.
You lost your husband. I lost my darling Annabelle. That poor boy Kieran. We've all lost something because of Colm. And that is why we will shepherd him to eternity.
Amen to that.
Now keep those fingers off those triggers, because we'll need cool heads and calm dispositions to see this done.
Practice what you preach, brother.
Whatever do you mean?
Are you gonna keep your cool? Really? When you seem to lose it all so often now.
This doubting and questioning of yours, I miss the old Arthur.
Don't we all?
You two quit it. We all got a job to do. We're all in rough agreement about how we're doing it. As far as I can tell.
Exactly.
We'll get it done, all right.
All right, then. Come on. We got a hanging to witness.
Look here. Don't the public love an execution? Hey. All right. Good. Now, you see that pair of assholes?
Sure.
They're Colm's boys.
Yes, I think so.
What a surprise. I'm glad we're here. What are they pointing at?
I don't know. We gotta follow them and find out.
Yeah. Oh. Here comes somebody. Stay here.
Don't do nothing.
Go brush that horse, officer.
Yes, sir.
The crowd came to see a show. We don't want to disappoint them.
I guess they did miss their chance to see John swing by his neck.
Hey. Hey. You know I wasn't going to let it come to that.
Well, I guess I don't know what I know no more.
And I guess this isn't the time to question either my decisions or yours. Here and now, Colm O'Driscoll's going to get his due. He's turned down there.
Watch out. There's that lowlife. Sure.
Let's go. Quiet.
bunch of cops.
How many?
Enough. So what do you think?
Paul's up on the roof. Once he starts shooting, we have to have our wits about us and move fast.
Yeah, I guess we faced worse than this before.
Sure. Let's get to it.
Yeah.
So, they got a guy up on the roof, overlooking the gallows. Find a way up there, onto one of these verandas, through a building maybe, and get him. And do it silently.
Well, obviously, I'm gonna do it silently. I wanna see this bastard swing.
Oh, Arthur. Here's a ladder. Find a way up to the roof and stop him. I'll go back to Mrs. Adler.
Just shoot her down. What's this, man? Gun case.
Times be barbaric. For sometimes a man is so savage, the only way to deal with him justly is by savagery. Colm O'Driscoll is one such man. He has murdered, tortured, robbed, stolen, raped, and abused for a decade across five states seemingly with impunity. Today, justice catches up with him.
As well you may. I've been a bad man.
Silence!
These charges...
This is not a court where you shall be tried. This is a place where your sentence is to be carried out. And your sentence, Colmo Driscoll, is that you are to be hanged by the neck until you are dead. This is not a task we take lightly. It is not a task we enjoy. But it is a task we must carry out if our civilization is to prosper. Gentlemen, are we ready? Colmo Driscoll, may God, in his infinite wisdom, have mercy upon your soul. Whenever you are ready.
Now you know how it feels to watch somebody you love die. You ruined my life!
Morgan! You hear us? Take a shot on these O'Driscolls!
It was a cold thing, so I'll bet you let them get between us.
I'm covering you!
How you get on, Arthur?
Well, we saw the bastard hang okay, but no thing ain't gonna save us.
I guess that's one less thing to worry about.
I guess, compared to the entire government, in the end, Colmo Driscoll didn't seem like such a worry.
A letter came for you.
Oh, okay.
I know it's from that Mary.
Mary?
She ain't worth it, Arthur.
Who is?
My dear Arthur, I don't know if you received the letter I wrote to you from Saint-Denis a while back. It was foolish of me to ask for your help again, and I promise there will be no recurrence. I don't imagine you'll receive this letter either, but I nonetheless must send it. Arthur. Oh, Arthur, I was just starting to dream the silliest and softest of dreams when I read about your recent activities in the newspaper. I miss you, and I will always miss you, but I cannot live like that. And it seems you cannot live any other way. When I'm with you, the world makes sense, but when we're apart, I... see clearly that your world is not a world from which one can escape. I am so sorry. For everything long ago, and for starting up that business again. There's a good man within you, Arthur, but he is wrestling with a giant, and the giant wins time and again. I enclose a ring you gave me many years ago, when we were both young. Not because I don't like it, but because I care for it far too much, and it reminds me too much of you. I hope one day you'll find some people in love who can use this, for it kept me thinking of you all these years. And I hope by returning it to you, I can finally be free. Goodbye, Mary.